Okay, so I thought I would just make a video just of rambling thoughts in a relaxing fashion and, see what happens with it. It's nothing pre-planned or anything. It's just my pure imagination going on here, and I just want to get some stuff out that's been rattling around in my brain for a while. And because I find it hard to write down in a diary and keep up. Diaries up to date and everything. I find that very hard. I wish I was better at it, but I find that doing these videos actually helps me a lot more in getting down what I want to say, because it's like I'm speaking, at least someone hears it in a diary, no one hears what I'm saying. So it's like a never-ending cycle of shit. So at least when I talk, someone out there hears. And even if they don't understand or really pay attention, it doesn't matter to me. It just matters that I'm passing this on to someone else, and they are hearing my thoughts. So today was a day that I was really profound in my life. It's very weird to talk about it. Going out into the world. Few nights I've been in my relaxation, at least once a week. I like to smoke marijuana and get high. I've had a long history with antidepressants, and they have not helped. They've helped to a certain extent, but not to the extent that I am cured of anything. So, in my desperation, I turned to training myself at least once a week to getting high, and just as a way of expelling all the demons and whatever. And just rewarding myself, because if you've never been high, you won't understand, but it is a feeling of pure energy, and it's like if when it goes right, there is nothing else like it. It's like nothing can go wrong. For someone with depression, it is like seeing a lighthouse in the middle of nowhere. It is that helpful. What I do is I lie down in the dark after I've smoked some weed. I'll just lie down and meditate and put on my iTunes or whatever, listen to random songs, and what I've done recently is I browse through photos that I've taken over the years and places that I've been, and it really gives me a sense of accomplishment and worth that I as being a human and existing in reality. That's what I feel. I'm being brutally honest here. And I feel that the human race is just a pathetic mass of flesh driving itself into oblivion. And it is really sad that I think this way, but from what I've seen and experienced in people that I meet, I just see no hope at all. But when I smoke marijuana and I get high, I feel like there is a sense of hope and a real worth to everything that I've done. I feel amazing. I feel incredible. And I guess that's why they call it a high, is because you feel things that you have forgotten. Like, when I get high, I can remember, and I look at a picture or something of where I've been. Like, for instance, say, New York. I went to New York in 2012. Without marijuana, I vaguely remember what I did over there. But when I smoke marijuana and I look at the pictures of me in New York, I can remember so vividly every little detail of what I experienced, and even like how cold it was on that day, what the weather was like, what I did every moment of that day. Like, it all comes flooding back, and that is a fucking miracle. It is just an incredible feeling, and it makes me appreciate being alive and doing the things that I've done. It really gives me a sense of worth and feeling that no other antidepressant has ever done for me at all. So I just want to say that about marijuana. The negative effects is what I felt today after smoking. And I went out in public, I went to work and everything, and I could just not deal with anyone at all. I think I was on the brink of having a panic attack, because I could still kind of feel the effects of the marijuana, and I kind of felt a bit self-conscious about everything. Like, should I be doing this? Should I be driving a car in this state? I kind of felt a bit weird. And then, you know, going through the day-to-day grind and things that normally wouldn't bother me too much really bothered me. Certain people that I usually want to avoid just became unbearable, and I was in a really horrible mood all day. I just wanted to avoid everyone. So I guess I experienced the downside of cannabis use, and it was a very horrible feeling. So I guess my tip here is, don't smoke when you have to work the next day, because I've been hitting it pretty hard over these past few days. I've been smoking every night and trying to get the most out of every second, and I've been having hardly any sleep. It all catches up to you in the end. And it is, the come down is really difficult, especially if you have problems with anxiety or depression. Now, I have heard a lot of people say on my other videos about depression medication, don't smoke weed, don't give it up, give up the ganja. And I say to them that marijuana has more or less saved my life, and in moderation. I've been, you know, hitting it a bit hard recently, but other than that, it is the one and only thing that has really helped me through depression in this past 2 years. I have felt and traveled to places in my mind that otherwise I would not even know existed. I've thought things that I would never have known otherwise. Moderate marijuana use is just absolutely eye-opening. And if it was more readily available to people all over the world, in moderation, I think, alongside use with antidepressants, it would cure so much mental illness. Now, there is a risk if you do have problems, if you do suffer from schizophrenia or something, it does make that even worse. But for the average person, the use here and there, the benefits are just enormous. I've been smoking just on and off for the past 2 years, pretty much. And my confidence level has soared. I've always had a problem with self-confidence and feeling okay within my skin. And right now, I am a completely different person to who I was 2 years ago. I am more self-confident. I am able to stand up for myself. If something is wrong, I'm willing to be more assertive. So this is kind of like a pattern of, I do a lot of cognitive behavioral therapy as well with my therapists, and it's all about, like, you can't win this battle against depression by medication alone, which I felt for many years. I just thought, oh yeah, I'll take a pill and I'll be all right. That does not work at all. And then I finally gave in and started doing therapy alongside my antidepressants. If you don't practice and learn what you hear in therapy, nothing will work. And then I finally, even, you know, I don't think therapy and antidepressants work completely. You'll never be cured properly. If you can't feel, it is very difficult to change your mindset. And what cannabis, drugs like cannabis and LSD do, or even ecstasy, like, I guess, they can give you insight into a perception that you never knew existed. It's another level of your consciousness that, if you've ever tried it, it is like the clouds opening on a, it's been raining and thunderstorms and everything on a real wintry day, and then the sun bursts through a patch of clouds, and you ascend up through the clouds, and all that you're above the clouds. That is what it feels like for me when I smoke marijuana. It is like the ultimate bliss. And I guess the thing that I have to learn to control is taking it in moderation and learning from what I discover on this amazing drug. And I am so glad that it is becoming legal in some states in the US. It will probably be forever. Until people wise up about this, but the benefits to discovering yourself and the true problems that lie at the core of your illness, it's just a no-brainer when it comes to using marijuana alongside therapy and traditional antidepressants, because I've tried so many antidepressants and most of them have had a negative effect on me. This is becoming a very long rant, and I hope you appreciate it. So, last night, yeah, I think I had a bad day today because last night I was lying down and I was watching, instead of the usual comedy stuff that I should be watching on when I'm smoking weed, I was watching videos of the September 11 attacks and videos of, I watched the Triumph of the Will, the film about Hitler's rise to power, the propaganda, the Nazi propaganda, and I watched footage of the Holocaust. Probably not the best thing to do when you're trying to get happy, but I want to, marijuana allows you to experience things that you have seen in a whole new light and feel a deeper appreciation for them. That's what I feel anyway, and it made me realize, like, how the fuck did anyone let this happen? How did this get so out of hand? These truly abominations of historical events that just were able to happen. And why did human beings, what made them think this way and decide that killing and destroying other people was worthy, was a worthy thing to do? I tend to watch a lot of videos on like on YouTube, like videos about the creation of the universe and how long we have and how difficult it will be galaxies and colonize planets that have the minute possibility of sustaining life that we have on Earth. And it just amazes me that we have allowed world wars to happen, genocide. Just, we continue to annihilate each other. For what purpose? There are so many galaxies and possibilities of life out there, and it really depresses me that we are wasting all our money and time and effort in building weapons and ways to kill each other, to wipe each other off the map, when we really should be trying to reach other galaxies and combining all our efforts. But I guess it really comes down to the evolution of the human mind and brain and our values and the way not one person is the same as the other. That is our downfall, I guess. And, you know, the way things are going, the way history, the way the world is moving, if we don't try and reach out into the galaxy within, say, even a million years, we will have annihilated ourselves, completely destroyed this planet that we are on. And no one, the sun will have, in a billion years, I think, will have become too hot, and it would have enveloped the Earth. It would have annihilated the Earth. And the sad history, sad realization of this is, if any other civilization out there in the universe, in the galaxies, the billions of solar systems that are out there, they wouldn't have even known that we have existed. That is what severely depresses me. And also the fact that in my day-to-day life, people complain about the most ridiculous fucking things imaginable. That just, I really find it hard to talk to people anymore. And I think, what can I do in my life, this time that I am given? And it really frustrates me. But at least with this channel, if I can reach out to people, if I can articulate what I feel, that is more or less a step in the right direction. So, I am glad to talk to you and discuss my thoughts and feelings, and it is better than having a therapy session, to be honest. Even if I didn't get any feedback or whatever, I'm just glad to document my thoughts, because it is too difficult to try and write down this stuff in a diary or anything. So thank you very much for listening, and I hope I don't sound like a crazy person. This is for your consumption. This this is my diary entry, and I hope this relaxed you and made you think about things. And I wish I could explain this to everyone that I meet, but it is too hard. So, thank you very much for watching, and I wish that we could all reach out into the night sky and aim for a better future. Thank you very much.